Welcome back! In today's video, I'll be showing you how to set up a keyboard on a Windows 11 PC or laptop. Whether you've just bought a new keyboard or want to make sure your current one is working correctly, this is the video for you. Remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe if the video helps. Let's get into the method. Firstly, you'll want to ensure that you are connecting the keyboard to the correct port. This will probably be a USB port, but you will need to check if your keyboard needs USB 2, which is the older USB port. If your keyboard isn't brand new, then it may be USB 2, and if you don't have any USB 2 ports on the front of your case, there should be some on the back of it. If one port doesn't work, then it's worth trying each of the ports on your PC until it does. If it still doesn't work, there might be another problem. Feel free to skip ahead a bit if your keyboard is working as it should. A quick way to check for problems is to troubleshoot your keyboard. You can do this by going to the main settings page, which can be accessed by searching for it. In the settings, go to System, then Troubleshoot, and then Other Troubleshooters. Now find Keyboard and click on Run next to it. Allow Windows to find and fix any problems. If your keyboard still doesn't work properly, then click the card on screen now to go to a video of mine that will show you some other possible solutions. Moving on, we'll now make sure that we have the latest drivers installed for our keyboard. You can do this whether your keyboard is working or not. Firstly, you might be able to download and install the latest drivers directly from the manufacturer's website. Search the make and model of your keyboard to see if they are available. We can also let Windows search for drivers for us. To do this, go to the Device Manager first. You can get here by searching for it. In the Device Manager, find the section that says Keyboards and click on the arrow to expand it. Now find your keyboard on the list. It's likely that it will be the only option, but you can always update the drivers for however many there are if you are unsure on which keyboard is the one you are using. Double click on it to open a new window. In this window, click on the Driver tab, which should be the second option. Now click Update Driver and then choose the Automatic option. Allow Windows to search for and install any driver updates if there are any. Depending on your keyboard manufacturer, there may be some software for you to download in order to customize it, for example if it has RGB lighting. The place to get this software will likely be included on or in the box, but check on the website if you are unsure. We'll now customize the keyboard settings within Windows 11. Head to the main settings page by searching for it, and then choose Time and Language from the list on the left. In here, click on Typing. There are some things in here that you can change, such as allowing for text suggestions, as well as other customizable options. The next settings that we can change can be accessed by going to the Control Panel, which can be found by searching for it. In the Control Panel, click on the blue View Devices and Printers link under where it says Hardware and Sound. Now find your keyboard, it should be somewhere on the top row. Right click on it and select Keyboard Settings. You can change the repeat delay, repeat rate, and test it, as well as change the cursor blink rate. Finally, there are a few more settings to change back on the main settings page. Choose Accessibility from the left and then scroll down and click on Keyboard. In here you can change things like turning off sticky keys, as well as other options. And so that is how to set up a keyboard on a Windows 11 PC or laptop. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you 10 easy ways you can speed up your Windows PC. Help support the channel by visiting the store, the link is in the description and at the end of the video. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below, and if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in another video.